All right, well, here I am starting the Catoctin Trail. Been waiting to do this for a year now. So, you know, I don't know if I can really put my thoughts into words, but I am more than excited. So, I'm going to turn off my phone, save battery, and update later. All right, so it's 10:10 about. I already ran into a problem. My hiking pole, it's like the strap got detached somehow, so I kind of got to work with this. It's not as nice because I can't like slay my wrist against it, but it's whatever. I'll figure it out when I stop for lunch. Besides that, crossed another larger stream, and my shoe is all wet. There's water in there. See, that one's dry, that one's wet. So, just gonna keep parking off and hiking onward. All right, here I am taking my first break. I'm about 3-4 miles in, I think. I'm kind of hungry, but I don't feel like opening my bear canister yet. I want to wait till I get to like a better stopping point, maybe like in an hour and a half or so. But I don't know, I'm just loving the scenery around here. Got all these crazy trees, like they're really thin, but they just bend every single way. There was one right there in the middle. And the weather is fucking beautiful. I couldn't ask for a better weekend. I'm glad it stormed yesterday so I wouldn't have to deal with that shit today. But anyways, gotta get back on the trail. Whoop. Alright, so it is 12:20. I'm about 6.5 miles in. Taking my first break, proper break. Making some lunch here. Got my socks and shoes off. They're still a little wet. I'm starting to get some hot spots, some blisters. So I'm going to take care of that with some duct tape. You know, good old-fashioned shit. So let me show the setup I got. Here, I just got my bag sitting next to me. I got my stove going right now. Some water boiling. I got something climbing on my neck. All right. I got my feet laid out. There's lunch today, sour cream and chives, mashed potatoes. I'm just chilling. I got my socks and shoes over there. Got my ass pad underneath me. Bear canister, trekking poles. So we're just chilling right now. It's tiring. I guess this is about as hard as I thought it was going to be. So I can't say I'm like surprised or anything. It's my feet hurt less. It's more of my neck, my shoulders. I'm trying to keep proper posture. Not sure how much that's helping, but I can still move my neck around, so I'm doing all right. man. I mean, you know, I may not sound excited. I even just listening to me talk right now, I almost sound kind of depressed, but you know, I've been wanting to do this for about a year now. I'm just happy. I'm content with where I am, you know. I mean, this is where I wanted to be. I think it's something I'll appreciate more once I get back home. Because right now I'm like, oh man, I'm fucking tired. My legs are fucking dirty. Got a stick poking me in the butt. But, it's really peaceful. It's quiet. It's green. So, I think I'm gonna eat some lunch, throw on some clean socks, and, get back to hiking. So, anyways, it's my lunchtime checking in, and let's just do one more. Let's see where we are. Beautiful. You can hear all the birds. The wind going through the trees. Alright, well, it's about 3:00. I'm at about the 10.5 mile mark. I am getting quite tired. I think not having fruit. You know, like some natural sugars, probably might have been. I have some Fig Newtons. Hope that helps me out. But you know, I'm just kind of asking myself, like, why the fuck did I do this? You know, it's like I'm fucking hiking with probably 40 pounds on my bag. I'm overweight. Bag's overweight. I'm not overweight. like hiking 16 fucking miles today and 10 miles tomorrow. It's like, why? Why, Joe? Why'd you fucking do this? And, you know, part of me is like, I don't know, because it's fucking easy. I just have to walk. But it's hard. Not just physically, mentally. It's, you know, it's really starting to kind of get to me. Thing I'm just telling myself is, well, you know, March 4th, gotta rep the brand. Gotta live the brand. But, you know, it's not easy. It is hard. And, you know, I'm willingly doing it. I'm consciously doing this. And I feel like, you know, by doing so, I'm really opening up even more possibilities. Because if I can fucking do this shit, you know, what can't I fucking do? I mean, I don't know, probably all this way, but run. So, but seriously, like, you know, I've gone through some hard times, you know, had some dumb shit happen. And, you know, it was more mentally tolling. But now it's like that mental pain I'm feeling physically. And it's creeping up into the mental. So it's rough, but I am marching forth. And I will get to the Manor campground probably around 6 o'clock, I think. I get to chill there, set up my tent, just chill, sit down properly. Let that dopamine flow in, you know? So, anyways, I will get back to hiking. I'm having a wonderful time. Currently have a bunch of gnats flying around my head. But this is the first time I've filtered water from like a stream. There's a little spring up here. And oh my God. This is some of the best fucking water I've ever had. This is amazing. And it's fucking ice cold. This is great. I couldn't ask for better water. I am so thrilled. This is a great morale boost. Yeah, so go spring water. All right, it is 4:30. I'm at the 13 and a half mile mark. And I was getting a little hungry, so I'm gonna have a little snack. I'm not gonna cook something. But oh my God, I just saw this big pond. There's a little trail that come off here. So I might go over there. It's a little more lush. This area is a little rocky. But man, I'm feeling good. This is fucking great. I love just chilling here. Like, no one else is here. It's just me in this fucking pond and the sun. So I think I'm gonna go do that. I'm gonna relax for a couple minutes, let my body kind of breathe, and then 2 miles left, man. The fucking trails here, like, I thought, you know, like, just the trails on the app I'm using, they have a difficulty thing. It said this was hard. I was like, nah, how could, like, I thought it was just hard because it was like 26 miles. No, or 28 miles, whatever the fuck. One website says 28, the app says 26. Oh, fuck it, no. I'm saying 28 because it makes me feel better. But, no, the trail itself is fucking hard to hike on. So, just a word of advice, anybody that wants to hike the Catoctin National Recreational Trail, it is hard as shit. So anyways, I'm gonna chill out and keep marching. All right, I think I'm on the last stretch of this part of the trail. It's kind of all downhill from here, but look at this. Thurmont Rock Overlook, baby. God. The view is so fucking worth it. Alright, back to hiking.
Okay, well, I got to the Manor camping area. Took me long enough. And apparently all the camping spots are reserved. I don't understand how I'm supposed to get a reservation considering all of the buildings here are closed and nobody's here. There's nothing online that I saw. You know, I hiked basically 17 miles today. That's good. I was really looking forward to setting up my tent and making some dinner. So it's Monday. I'm just looking at the videos I recorded while I was hiking. I realized I didn't really explain what happened at the end. Basically, to reserve a camping spot, you have to actually go to the campsite earlier in the week and grab like a piece of paper, like a laminated piece of paper off of like a big clipboard thing that they have there. And that's how you self-register. There is no information online that that's what you had to do. No reviews or anything said that that's what you had to do. So I guess maybe that's a new thing that they implemented with the pandemic, but it'd be nice if there was some information there. Besides that, oh yeah, and nobody was worried. No, like I called like 3 times and nobody answered earlier last week. And, you know, I get there and it's like, yeah, all of the buildings are closed. There's like caution tape and it's like, oh, we're closed because of COVID-19. And for whatever reason, they're too good to come back to work yet. I didn't end up camping out. I just called my dad. He was nearby, so he was able to just pick me up. Grabbed some food and he drove me back to my car and came home. It sucks because I was really looking forward to camping out, you know, doing the stuff, making dinner, waking up in the tent. But I'm kind of glad I didn't, because as it turns out, my pack really was overweight. I seriously hurt myself like yesterday, Sunday. I could barely walk, and I just, it wouldn't have been good. I couldn't have done like the 12 more miles. So, you know, everything happens for a reason. I think it's a good thing that I didn't end up hiking the next day. But you know, now I know what I need to do. Now I know what I need to like drop off and like what I should bring next time, what things I need to replace. Also, fuck that trail. It's really fucking hard. So my next trip is probably going to be at the end of this month. I'm planning on going up to Michigan, see my brother, and we're going to do a trail up there. It should be around like 30 something miles. It should be a lot easier because up in Michigan, everything's a lot more flat. So I'll have fun with that, and I'll get some more videos, some more pictures, and keep uploading and marching forth. So anyways, this was my first attempt at the Catoctin National Recreational Trail. So till next time.